They're easy to recognize because they wear red vestments. They're known as prelates, princes of the church, eminence, or simply as cardinals of the Catholic Church. In essence, they're the Pope's advisors.
Because I'm a cardinal, periodically the Pope will ask the College of Cardinals as an entity or individual cardinals to help him in wider work on behalf of the worldwide church.
They are created cardinals by the Pope in a public ceremony known as a consistory. One by one, they make their way to the Pope as he officially gives them their new title and blessing. They have direct access to the Pope and can easily request a personal meeting. Back at home, they usually lead their local diocese or archdiocese. Despite being from different parts of the world, they take regular trips to Rome to touch base with the Pope and the Vatican. This includes keeping the Pope up to date on the challenges and strengths of the church in their region, and also giving recommendations and local insight on how the church should respond. Those based in Rome usually lead Vatican departments and make up part of the Roman Curia. When compared to the Universal Church, the number of cardinals is relatively small. There are about 210 of them, from which roughly 110 are cardinal electors. As a group, they're known as the College of Cardinals. Perhaps the greatest responsibility of all comes during the conclave, when cardinals come together to elect the Pope during the so-called sede vacante. That's when cardinal electors, meaning those who are younger than 80 years of age, elect the Pope inside the Vatican Sistine Chapel.